ships are sinking. Men are dying. It is September 1939. While German panzer divisions race toward Warsaw, the German Navy, powerful, efficient, its morale high, prepares for a greater, more decisive struggle, the Battle of the Atlantic. Hitler's admirals know that command of the sea means the death of Great Britain and victory in Europe. They also know if the stronger Royal Navy bars the way on the surface, victory may be won in the depths. At the outbreak of war, they begin expanding their U-boat fleet by as much as 1,000% a month. Germany's ablest scientists and technicians concentrate on perfecting the submarine, multiplying its range and deadliness. For fascism to survive, it must kill. The time has come, and Hitler hurls his U-boats into the Atlantic to ravage and destroy. The elite of the Nazi Navy, its best commanders, its most highly trained crews, man the submarines. To them falls the crucial mission of isolating Great Britain, of severing the arteries that feed her. If enough of England's ships are sunk, the issue will not be in doubt. England starves. Europe dies. As war begins, England expands her now hopelessly inadequate merchant marine. In addition, hundreds of escort vessels are desperately needed to protect the cargo ships. For months to come, they will be pitifully few.